Our mental health has taken a beating during the pandemic, no doubt, but mental health experts say COVID-19 should not take all of the blame. In fact, they expect depression levels to remain even higher over the pandemic's end. Here's our Why Guy, all new this morning.
It didn't start with COVID-19. When it comes to depression, the situation certainly got worse during the pandemic. According to the World Health Organization, worldwide levels of anxiety and depression increased 25% in the first year of the pandemic. But experts say the issue didn't begin there, nor will it end there. The WHO predicts that depression will move from third to the leading contributor to disease worldwide by 2030.
Depression has been a pandemic for longer than COVID has been a pandemic.
Let's explore why health experts believe depression levels will remain high long after the pandemic. Atlanta psychiatrist Dr. Suvat Bhargava says depression levels have been rising for generations.
The world has in some way become a smaller place. We're witnessing more and experiencing more secondary trauma, meaning by watching what other people are going through. Also, social media has been a factor.
The WHO's World Burden of Health study found young people raised during the social media generation are among the hardest hit.
There's more a message of perfection, which puts on a whole different burden and leads to high rates of anxiety.
The WHO reports that the pandemic has exposed gaps in mental health care in some parts of the world, including a lack of online resources.
There is still the stigma. But the more we talk about these things, these conversations are going to make a real difference.
Left untreated, depression can lead to suicide, the fourth leading cause of death for people between the ages of 15 and 29.